Japanese people never say lovely, right? I have never seen like a Japanese boy like lovely. Like when I was in Canada, like people like trying to like kiss him like in front of me. Like I was like,
we don't do that. We don't leave our kids.
Like in Japan, like a mother and have to take care of babies like that.
Yes.
Yeah, like
it's not. We don't have the culture of babysitters here. Like we have some babysitters, you know, but it's very normal that we, like mom need to take care of the baby.
Yeah. Like, for example, if I have a baby and then like a baby to take care, like just one day, and then maybe people would say like, why you like hang out without like a baby? Like, yeah, they like to say something like a bad, right?
I've seen like in like American movies, like a very young kid. They just leave them to the babysitters, and they like you know, married couples. They just go to a date. So nice, I think.
Yeah.
Like dinner or some date. Just you know, leaving the kids. I think it's a good culture, but we don't do that. We don't leave our kids.
Yeah. One of the YouTubers who leave like a babies to like a. They're like a mother and then they hunger and then a lot of like Japanese people say like something bad. Why like you are mother, you're supposed to take care of like a baby, like, you know?
Only one day, right?
Just one day.
I think it's okay. Like mom has to have a day off.
Yeah. It's like a really culture, like a different culture, right? I just realized like Japanese people like after Japanese people go married like we tend to not touch each other, no kissing, no like friendship. Like a foreigner asked me about like that question, like and what do you think? Like I think like a foreigner, even they like after go married like they try to food each other and then go to somewhere without baby.
Oh,
and, but in Japan, it's not common.
Yeah, I agree. Like, they start to call each other mother, mom, dad. Never call them with their names.
Yeah.
No, that's not. Like, they change their mind of loving. Of course, they love each other, but different way of love. I think like family love more like.
Yeah, and I have dated with like a foreign guy, and then I just realized that like a foreign like boys tend to say like love you, not tend to say like they can say love you, but Japanese people never say love you, right? I have never seen like a Japanese boy like love you.
Not direct way of saying love, like more hidden. We never kiss in public.
We never.
I was so surprised when I was a kid, like I saw someone kissing in public.
Oh yeah. Like, when I was in Canada, like people like trying to like kissing like in front of me. Like I was like, where do I like look at? Like, you know?
Yeah.
It's in Japan, in common, right?
Yeah, so that. Probably hugging. We don't hug.
Yeah, like even like a family, we don't say love you, right?
Oh no, yeah.
We don't say, right? Yeah, I think like we should say like love you more, like to like our family.
Like maybe aishiteru, like you know, I love you in Japanese is aishiteru. So it's like aishiteru and love you is like a different sounds. I feel like. So we just need to adjust love you. Like love you is easy to say, but aishiteru is like a so heavy voice.
That's what I really wanted to say. Like in Japanese, like love you in Japanese is aishiteru, and which means really like a sounds heavy, right? I don't know why.
We say sukida yo, suki. Like it's like a more like I like it. I like you. Yeah, but I still feel like
it's kind of heavy.
You have some burden.
You have some burden.
And we don't have like a hug each other. Actually, yeah, I was so surprised when I was in Canada. Like, everybody tried to hug, like, even in the first time, like, meet like people.
Very
and,
friendly.
Yeah, actually. That is a really good culture, like hugging each other.
I liked it.
Yeah. I feel like it's gonna be really like a friendly more like.
Oh yeah. You feel like more attached to the someone.
Yeah.
Hug you.
I really like a hugging culture.
Right? You can smell the you know scent of the someone. Then you perfume.
Yeah,
one thing, like a perfume culture is not common here in Japan too. Like, I smelled more perfume in Australia. Like, more people have some perfume and I like it. But here, maybe, before people used to put more perfume in Japan. Maybe because we are wearing masks.
I've heard that random rumor of like foreign people like they put perfume because they don't take a shower. And I don't know, one of my friends told me have you heard of that? And they got because like a foreigner put the perfume all the time because they don't take a shower and
I was like shower.
I don't know, like, I was like, are you sure? And she was like, yes,
yeah.
But she had never like lived in other country. That was like not like true
urban like
yeah. Like what? And then when I went to Canada and then I asked Canadian people is that true, and then they are like, no way.
They're hygiene, of course.
I was so surprised. I think Japanese people have never been abroad. They just imagine
a stereotype, I think. My dad often say that you shouldn't date with a foreign guy because maybe also difference food, the smell. But my dad doesn't have many foreign friends, so that's why
So today, thank you for watching and thank you for coming.
Thank you for inviting.
Yuka-chan.
So nice.
We will collaborate soon as soon as possible. Thank you and thank you for watching and have a nice day.
Toilet paper size is really big in Canada. When I go to the when I go to the toilet, I always the toilet paper is really big. Canadian toilets, there is a space. You know, we can see somebody's feet, obviously, right?
Yes, the door is widely open. The bottom area is kind of open, but we never open.
When I was watching American show, they don't really take off shoes.
Just jump on the bed.
Yeah.
Well, I think they like to make the bed, making the bed clean,
And thank you for watching and please subscribe to our channel too.
And if you like this video, please hit like button and subscribe.
Subscribe our channel and thank you.
See you next time.
Bye.
Have a good day.